Salem Aerial. For aerial photos, videos, mapping, and inspections, visit salemaerial.com.
Okay, Shalise, and do you represent an organization?
Yes, we are a collective organization of about 5 or 6 Facebook groups that have started kind of from all over the state, who initially we each, kind of just in our own communities, felt the need to speak up for advocating for in-person school. And from that, quickly learned that there was others around the state that felt the same way. So we have come together and make up an organization with over nearly 40,000 people in Oregon. And so we are happy to represent and do whatever we need to do to help represent those people.
Okay. So what's your goal here today?
So our goal today is to show Governor Brown and the Oregon Department of Education and the Oregon Health Authorities that school is absolutely essential, and that the current metrics that they have in place are unattainable and need to ideally be dropped, to be honest. But we are fighting and hoping that our kids will be able to get back to school, and not even just, you know, we will take anything at this point. I mean, these kids have been suffering for nearly a year.
If Governor Brown was standing here, what would you like to say to her?
Oh, we would say, first of all, look at these kids. I mean, really, look at these kids.
Yeah.
These kids are suffering. These kids are really suffering. Not just educationally, which is huge, but more emotionally, mentally, socially. And I don't know how you can look in the eyes of those kids right there and think that what you're doing, and knowingly that there are so many other states around us that are making this happen, and these kids are, look at the science. They say follow science, and I would just beg her to just look at it. These kids need to be with other kids. They need to be with their teachers. We need her to, you know, be the trailblazer and do it. Just follow the science.
Do you think that Governor Brown's, she says a lot that our values and our us and values, she uses those words a lot. Do you think that right now Governor Brown represents your values when it comes to the, okay?
In short answer, no. I feel like, and I think I can speak for most of the group and the people here maybe, that she claims she does, but the actions speak much louder than words. And we feel like right now the agenda, and you know, number one on her list is either federal funding or you know, a next step in the political game. But absolutely, children are nowhere on the list, and we feel like she is just really great at using them, you know, as pawns, is sort of making everybody else feel like it's our job to make this happen, when in reality, there are states next to us, all around us, that are doing this very successfully.
Okay. If you could say anything you wanted to the legislature, maybe, you know.
Yes. We would say somebody. If you have an ounce of urgency to get any kids back in school in a timely manner, speak up. Please, do not feel like you are the minority or that you will get shut down quickly. Please speak up, be brave. Make an ally with somebody and work for the state of Oregon for the kids. I mean, this has gone on far too long, and it is far from over.
Do you feel a little abandoned?
Yes. We feel a little abandoned, especially when we hear press conferences that, frankly, the last one didn't say the word students and schools at one time in the hour and a half. Nothing. So when we feel like we're left out to dry by school districts, by superintendents, by other teachers, by, you know, people who just, we feel like we're shouting to a brick wall sometimes with no real concrete answers.
Anything else you'd like to say, directed at anyone you'd like to direct it at?
We know that the coronavirus is a real thing. We acknowledge that. We acknowledge the risk and the numbers and all of those things. However, we also acknowledge the fact that Oregon has been
misrepresenting the data and the positivity rate. And we are quite frankly sickened by that. And if we would have actually done it correct the first time, then these kids would have, and followed those metrics, those kids could have been back in school months ago when the positivity rate said it was 12%, but it actually would have been 6% under the governor's metrics at the time. So please just advocate, somebody speak up. If you feel anything, do it, because we need to. This is the first big hurdle, is our state level to remove the metrics and give the power locally to school districts.
To wrap it up, if you know any, you talked about other states and you talked about metrics. Do you know any numbers about some of the states that have open schools?
Yes. So a lot of other states, to be honest, they don't have exact numbers and metrics. Now, what that means is they just say it's up to the school districts in your community to kind of follow. They have numbers, but there's no set metrics that have to be in place for them to get to. For example, even in California, there was a lot of districts that were able to go. Their numbers were 100 to 100,000 when ours were 10, right? So, I mean, Oregon is extremely under the cutoff for any of this.
Awesome to feel safe. Kate Brown, Oregon Legislature, OHA, please move them up the list for those who want the vaccine. Finally, in terms of schools, we need to focus on ventilation. Ventilation is the key here. It's not hygiene theater. It's not spraying down every surface. It's ventilation. School districts should have a plan to ventilate their schools to allow a safe return to schools. Now, one thing I'd like to point out is that the CDC came out today with the three states that have the lowest rates of coronavirus. Number one is Vermont. Number two is Maine. Any guesses to what number three is? That's right, Oregon! So we can open schools safely.
At Western Pacific Roofing, our residential team can provide all of your roofing needs. 503-588-7663.